David.
Morning, gang.
Good morning, David and Chris.
Morning, all.
Everybody.
That's a humidifier behind you, right, Chris?
What's that?
Is that a humidifier behind you?
Yes, my house is not on fire.
That's what it looks like.
Or it's a fog machine.
I see white smoke.
Yeah, that's it's a humidifier.
Yeah.
I have to keep my room somewhere in the 50s because it's filled with guitars.
Oh.
So it takes a lot of steam, a lot. So this thing is running constantly, and some days it looks like a lot more than others if it's really dry in here. So yeah, Nancy saw that once. And
I thought you were on fire.
Yeah, she thought my room was on fire.
Yeah.
I was trying to save you. Though when you do play the guitar, sometimes you are on fire.
There you go. That's what I say.
I thought I was at a Pink Floyd concert.
Yeah, it's very similar. Smoke machines are the best. But Nancy, it took her, she still was polite, even though she thought my room was on fire. Like, she was waiting for other people to finish talking to tell me that my room was on fire.
Yes, well.
Which I found very funny. She was like, oh, I'll wait my turn to let Chris know that his house is probably
there are emergencies, and then there are emergencies, you know?
That's a good point. That's a good point.
Well, I was going to step in finally, but I didn't want to be rude. You know, I am a girl. I'm a Girl Scout at heart. So now, are we recording right now?
Yes.
Okay. Well, you know what? I'm just going to say it. So I just want to let everybody know my house went up on the market Saturday at 1 o'clock, and by Monday we had 9 offers on the house.
Wow.
So.
Wow, where is your house?
It's in Montgomery. I live in Belmead. Over by the park.
We are in Belmead too.
Yeah, I live over behind the soccer fields, and across the other way is where we played ukulele in the park.
Well, congratulations. That's
a good area. So it's a seller's market right now?
I guess so, yeah.
Yeah, it seems like it.
It's been.
Should we sell a house?
It's crazy. So if you've got, if you've got a pool, that is a huge factor. So that was what everybody was looking for, was the pool, so.
Oh, wow. So
I had it
offers.
All.
That's pretty good.
I know. It was crazy. So
where are you moving to?
Fix your screen.
Fix my screen. Oh, I didn't brush my hair yet, and I'm going downstairs to get my coffee.
Are you look smart.
Yeah.
You're stunning.
We bought a home in Florida.
Oh, wow.
So, but don't worry. We want to do the ukulele cruise. I'm there.
I'm going to figure out a way to do that. I'll fly back up.
We can go right out of Bayonne or what's the other one? What's the better, the more fun ship is the Norwegian.
We could really feasibly do like a harbor cruise for sure. I don't know about, a cruise to the Bahamas or anything unless.
Well, are you saying you're boat locked. You don't want to be boat locked with your band?
No, I would. It's just that. It's just that we'd have to take
a ukulele with. Every cruise is a ukulele cruise.
That's true. I would really do that with you guys, but we'd have to take up the collection for me to afford it. That's the problem. Like,
I'll donate $10, God.
If we did that, I would totally go.
Well, hey, we can pass the chip jar around, when we're playing the ukulele, we could have just like in New York City.
In steerage, Chris.
That might work. That might work.
Double coal.
I wouldn't mind. Maybe just get the room way down at the bottom of the boat or by the engine room or something.
You'd be down there with the crew. We would be like, where's Chris? And they'd be like,
fine by me.
The crew.
I don't care where my bed is. Ken, you look good, man. Welcome back.
Thank you. I owe it all to you. I caught the virus.
Oh, yeah? That was not me.
I've been in isolation for 2 weeks.
Oh, man.
My quarantine ends after tomorrow.
Well, congratulations. Okay. I mean, you got through it okay. I'm glad to see that.
Thank you.
Yeah. Glad to see that.
Oh, good. It's good to hear.
It really is luck of the draw, man. Some strains are really, really bad, and some you can get through okay, you know. It's like a lottery, you know.
Yeah, all I've had is a head cold.
Wow, that's fantastic. That's really good to hear.
But I owe it all to you.
You're welcome. You're welcome, Ken. I'm glad you could help.
My daughter and my grandson that I live with both got it, and I didn't.
You're very lucky.
I am very lucky, because that five-year-old, he's all over me all the time.
Yeah.
So I don't know if I didn't get it, knock on wood, but I'm glad. Now I've had my second shot, so I'm good.
He's a five-year-old, too? You're very lucky. Very lucky. Holy Christmas.
He was laying on me, and we played games, and, you know.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, that's a good thing. I mean, there's no guarantee, you know, living with someone that they're going to get it. It's just, it's a very weird luck of the draw kind of thing. You know, some people get it right away. Some people don't get it at all.
Yeah.
You know, some people get it and they don't even know they have it because they don't get any symptoms at all, you know? And those are the most dangerous people because they're going around spreading it all over the place and they don't even know they're doing it, you know? So it's a really weird disease in that way that there's, and then the symptoms, there's so many different symptoms. I mean, some people just get, like Ken said, like a head cold, and then some people get so bad they can't even breathe and they need oxygen, you know?
Yeah.
it's just bizarre. It's bizarre how it works. It's bizarre how you know, it affects people very differently.
Yeah. You know, Has anybody gotten their shot?
Yeah.
We just got it yesterday, second dose.
Oh, great.
Wait, Ken, you got your shot like recently?
Yeah, a week before I was diagnosed.
Oh, a week before you were diagnosed. Okay. After you're diagnosed, you got to wait 3 months, they said.
No, March 11th is my next date.
March 11th?
For the second shot.
Well, I'd keep that for sure. I mean, they told me that I can't get it for 90 days because I had COVID. So I don't know. Maybe I'll still sign up for it and just see what happens.
Yeah, sign up. Worst thing that can happen is they tell you to wait.
Right, exactly. Yeah, that's a good point.
You gotta wait 90 days after you've had COVID before you can get the shot?
That's what the doctor told me. Yeah, and they told me the same thing when they called, when the county called me. Because after you test positive, the county calls. And they give you all the information. You gotta, you know, and really all they said to me was you gotta quarantine for 10 days. That's it. That's all they said. And then he said, I asked him, I said, you know, can I get the shot? And he said, you've got to wait 90 days before you get the shot.
That's so, because your antibody is good for 90 days.
That's for the first shot, right?
For the first shot. Yeah, that's what it is. So
yeah, I've already had the first shot.
Yeah. So that's probably why you're going to get the second shot. No problem.
Right.
Because you have antibodies for 90 days, so you can't really get you can't get COVID again for at least 90 days. And even so, the amount of people who've got it twice is like in the single digit percentile. I mean, very, very, very few people get it twice. It almost never happens. So although I would be that lucky few, you know, that's my luck. That's, you know.
But, how's your mom feeling?
She's much better. Much
okay.
better. Yeah.
And Sal?
Sal's good. Sal's...
And Phyllis didn't get it?
I don't know. Maybe. I don't want to reveal any medical information that,
right.
You know, my mom doesn't want to reveal.
So, no, that's a personal thing, but
yeah.
And your sister's fine.
My sister's fine. Yeah, everybody's fine. I'll just put it Excellent. That way. Everybody's fine. Yeah. My sister's just a little upset that, you know, we actually talked about it in the beginning. Like, I should just give it to her. So then we can both quarantine. We can both quarantine at the same time. You know, like maybe we should share a cup or something because, yeah. You know, because she ended up getting it towards the end of when I had it and then she had to quarantine again.
Okay. You know? So yeah. She's just asymptomatic.
Well, she's got a little bit of a, you know, she had a little bit of a head cold briefly, but yeah, basically, she's been fine. So we all got incredibly lucky.
Yeah, so happy to hear that.
Yeah, thank you. All right. Well, we've got three songs, David, that I didn't know from the song list this week. The rest of them I basically did. Let's see what we have on the list here. I wrote it down. Oh no, we had A Teenager in Love, Our House, People Got to Be Free, and We've Only Just Begun. There's four songs.
Oh, We've Only Just Begun. That one's with the tough chords.
Yeah, that had hard chords in it.
You go for it, David.
That one's tough. That one's tough.
Faith in you.
Dave, do you want to do any of A Teenager in Love?
Sure.
Yeah, okay. That one is page 271. Why must I be a teenager?
Whatever.
Ken got it.
Ken knows. There you go. All right, here we go.
To see if I can scrape up a voice this morning.
That's the tough part, man. Yeah. That's the thing about mornings. All right, everybody's muted. Let me share the screen. Did I share it? No.
Not yet, no.
Got it now?
Okay. So we're Island Strong?
Yep.
All right. So it's I cry to you. I cry to you. Nobody. Okay. Okay. With the intro, that's one, two, one, two, three, four. Nobody but you.
Great job.
Oh, thanks.
That sounded great. Well, all right, what do we got? We've got Our House, People Got to Be Free, and We've Only Just Begun, which is very difficult. But do you know either Our House or People Got to Be Free?
Yep.
Okay. You know them both.
It's a very, very, very fine house.
Yeah, I know that part, but I don't think I know the rest of it. Oh, no.
Oh, with two cats in the yard. Life used to be so hard.
Now
Nancy knows it. Nancy knows it.
I thought it was the other one. It's a band from the 90s or something. Our House in the middle of the street. That one I don't really know. But that's when you said Our House, that was the one I was thinking of.
Yeah, this song was written by Graham Nash about his place with Joni Mitchell, and they wrote it after going lamp shopping.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah?
Look at you. You're like a TMZ program.
Well, no, that's a story about this place. They were an item for a really long time, and they had a place together, and they went lamp shopping, and they talk about the lamp that they bought in the song.
Nice.
Yeah, it looks. I can see that. I never even thought about that. There's a couple of chords in here that are a little bit weird.
Yes. So do you want to do this, Nancy, or you're muted?
Nancy, you're muted.
Right. I thought I was unmuted. I think I could do this one.
Okay. And don't forget the A major seventh is the third and fourth string on the first fret. F minor is like a G seventh, only up one string. And that's about it.
Okay.
So if you want to give it a try.
I will.
Here you go.
All right.
Hold on. Okay.
All right. One, two, one, two, three, four. I light the fire. You place the flowers in the vase that you bought today. All night long for me. while you place the flowers in the vase that you bought today. I kept getting the F in the A. I kept forgetting to put my finger down for the F.
Our house is a very fine house.
Yes.
Yes, yes. Yes, and our singer is a very fun.
That's right.
Singer and player.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
How about People Got to Be Free, Dave?
Yep.
All right.
All right.
It's in a different key than the original, but you got it.
All right. I don't know that this necessarily is a is an Island Strum song. It's more like a that kind of thing. It is a little bit of a, it is a little bit of a swingy kind of a gospel feel to it. That's the rhythm. I don't know what you would call it. But that's it. So that's a 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, it's easy to see. I think I left anything out, right?
No, that was perfect. I sorry about that. as I'm scrolling, sometimes I'll over scroll and then it skips.
The verses are Island Strum, and the choruses are that other kind of a rhythm to it.
Gotcha. Yeah.
So we need to adjust that, maybe.
Yeah. I think it still might be the Island Strum, but it starts and stops at each chord, right? So it feels different. We will have to look into that. I think that's it. I mean, we've got You've Only Just Begun, but that's, I'm gonna need to sit down and really go through that to learn it, because there's a lot of chords in there. It's tough. That's another piano song in there.
Let's take a look at it.
Okay.
Hey, Chris, what was the first?
I think song? I may have.
What was the first what, D? What was the
first song that we just did?
The first song we did was Teenager in Love.
Teenager in Love. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, that was page 271.
Oh, perfect.
We've only just begun.
Okay. Let's see what's interesting here. Why don't we give it a shot?
Okay.
Do you know the song, Chris?
I do not.
Oh, okay. I'll give it a shot.
Okay. I've heard the song before, but I only really know the first verse, maybe. So, yeah, go ahead. Give it a shot, man.
Okay. We can do this. Okay, we can do this one. Let's just make sure that I know everything here. That's it. Okay. With the intro. So one, a two, a one, two, three, four. We've only just begun to live. White lace and promises, a kiss for luck, and we're on our way. On our way. We've only I'll sing a line here. A kiss for luck, and we're on our way. We've only just begun before the rising sun. We fly so many roads to choose. We start at walking and learn to run. And yes, we've just begun. Oh. Snap. Where's E? Where's that A? Where's that A major 7? Staring near to us. Taking it. Where's it? Of three, third fret, taking it over just the two of us. My finger can't work into together day to day together. We smile. So much of life ahead. We'll find a place, there's room to go. And yes, we've just begun. Sharing a together day together and when the evening comes we smile so much of life ahead. We'll find a place that and yes, we've just begun. It's that one passage that's really tough in there. That A flat to the C sharp major seven.
Yeah, that's tough.
It goes like... I just kind of wasn't prepared for it.
Yeah, that's very difficult.
And the E to the A major seventh is no picnic either.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, Dave, thank you for giving it a shot. Because you're right, there were some parts that I could sail right through because it's such a beautiful song,
yes.
But then there's that one line
that
it was tough.
Bridge is a bastard.
Right, I know, it's not only the chords, but then you're like, oh yeah, you're gonna go down 1 2 3, and then you're counting 1 2 3.
As soon as I figured out where they were, it got a little bit easier.
Did we do your song? I feel like that's where we ended off, or did we do that?
I
think we did Kokomo.
I know we did Kokomo. I'm pretty sure we ended off when I did My Girl.
Yeah, we did.
I think your song is the one we're on now. I mean, even if we do play it again, it's a good song. Hi, Mom.
Hey.
Everybody saying hello.
Oh, hello, everybody.
All right.
Is Celeste here by any chance?
No.
All right, I have to send the link to her daughter. Okay. I was just double checking. All right, see you later, guys.
Bye, Denise.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
I think I can sing this one if you guys want me to take this one.
Sure, you could take it if you want.
What's the G sus four? What is that one again?
It's a G, but
I see it.
Okay.
Okay. All right, I'll give it my best shot. Island strum, and we'll do the intro.
You got it.
Elton John. Okay. Has anybody watched the series Killing Eve?
I don't think so.
So I'm just at a point where she's visiting her family in Russia, and they're all like huge Elton John fans. They like wear the boas with the sunglasses and everything. All right. One, two, three, four. An A minor G, major minor G, G potions and a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. And you can tell Thank you. So this A minor G, I don't like it. So how do I get past it?
Well, don't do it.
Oh, I see. Oh, I was trying to do the G in the A minor and I didn't look over at the chords. I like that. Okay.
Yeah, it's only two fingers.
It was messing me up big time. You know when you just can't get past something?
Yeah.
Yeah. Definitely.
Yeah, I do.
Only too well.
All right. I feel like we did this one, but it wouldn't be too bad to do again. Okay. All right. Just the island strum for this. All basic chords we should have. We should have down. And all right. One, two, three, four. Day after day, I'm all confused. You know rock and roll and drift away. Give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. Wanna get lost in your rock and roll and drift away. Oh, give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. I wanna get lost in your rock and roll and drift away.
Great song.
Thank you.
We need to add that song for our cruise list. So we have to start compiling a list for our cruise. So that was a good one.
Okay.
That's a good sing-along.
That's a good one.
I hate to say it, I would probably love doing that.
Yeah, it's a good song.
Can we hit Alaska while we're out there?
Oh man, I'm going to Iceland.
But if we're going on a cruise with our ukes, we have to do Sea of Love.
Come with me to find.
Right, Jane?
Yeah. And don't rock the boat. Yeah. Don't rock the boat, baby.
I want to tell you.
That's a good song. That's a good one. There's a lot of seafaring songs we have in here. We've got Jamaica Way. We've got
John B.
Yep, Sloop John B. That's a good one. Yeah, we could find a bunch of boat related songs, I'm sure.
Sitting on the dock of the bay.
That's right.
That's a good one too.
Roll away.
Yep. All right. Well, next is Build Me Up Buttercup, which is also a good sing along song. Yeah, I know. I'm yawning too. I can't stop doing it. No, it's all right. I don't know what's going on with me this morning. I'm like yawning every 10 minutes, not even. All right. Okay. One, two, one, intro, three, four. But I could be the boy you adore.
want. If you just let me know. Although you are true, I'm attracted to you all the more. Why do I need you so? Hey, 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 baby, baby, I try to find, hey, 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 a little time. I'll make you mine, hey, hey, be home. I'll be beside the phone waiting for you.
A good one.
All the leaves are brown.
Also true. California dreaming. Yeah. California. The West Coast is the one place I haven't been yet. But I hear California is very similar to Texas weather-wise.
No. I lived in San Diego for 23 years. No, it's absolutely perfect almost every day of the year.
So is Texas.
No, Texas is humid and hot and muggy and yuck.
It's like 74 degrees and perfect all the time in Texas.
No, it's muggy.
I didn't find it that muggy. I mean, I lived there for over a year.
Yeah, I don't know. I visited my son in Houston plenty of times, and it was just like soggy, muggy.
Really? Maybe it is more humid there than I give it credit for. I don't remember that too much. I believe you, though.
Well, you don't get any in San Diego or L.A.
Well,
once in a while, people would say to me, oh, it's so muggy. And I'm like, really? Have you ever lived anywhere else? Because this is not muggy.
Yeah, well, that is true. I mean, people are weird in other states. Like, I know in Texas, when it would slip below 60 degrees, people would walk around in like parkas and wool hats and stuff. And I'm like, I'm walking around in a t-shirt and flip-flops. Like, what is wrong with you people? Like, it's beautiful outside today, you know? But I've never been to California, so I have nothing to compare it to. Although, isn't LA really like gross smog-wise and all that kind of stuff? Yeah. Like,
not really.
That's why I was.
My parents live in LA.
Oh, they live in LA?
Yeah, I like the weather there. And I myself live in Texas for 3 years.
And you like it better in California?
The difference is Texas is more like a desert.
More like the desert.
And there's a snow, but no snow in LA.
Yeah.
LA has improved a lot pollution wise.
Oh, really?
With the new emissions standards in cars.
Yeah. Well, that's good. That's good. I mean, if more people switch over to at least better emission cars and hopefully at some point electric cars, we could get rid of most of that pollution altogether, you know?
In 3 years. Yeah, everyone switched to electronic cars.
Oh, man. Well, like I said, I'm going to be driving gasoline cars for a long time. If they force me to switch, they better pay for an electric car. Because those are ridiculous money right now. Hopefully, if they start becoming more affordable, then yes, absolutely. But, you know, Tesla is crazy expensive. Although they have more consumer grade electric cars now.
Right, and they're $30,000.
Yeah. There's some around that price. Yeah.
Yeah, my son just bought a beautiful Prius. Believe it or not, he went from a Lexus to a Prius. And he hasn't put gas in the car once. He's been running on the electricity.
Yeah, that's amazing. That's amazing.
It plugs it in at home, so it doesn't cost me any money at home.
It does. It does. It makes a lot of sense. I mean, electric cars are definitely, it makes a lot of sense. Yeah. All right, let's get this song in because we're basically out of time, but we'll do one more. All right. But I will go to California at some point and I'll report back my my findings. I'll let you know. I do believe you, though. I believe you that it's less muggy there. And there's no chance of a deep freeze like Texas just had in California either. So that's a big deal. All right.
I wouldn't be so sure about that.
That's true. That is true. Texas wasn't prepared for this at all.
Right.
You know, yeah. Yeah, we haven't seen weather like that down there in a long time. All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. All the leaves are brown and the sky is gray. Everybody do the same. Take care, Ron.
Chris, see you tomorrow.
Yes, Dee.
You go to California, you won't come back.
I don't know about that, man. I don't know. I've heard that it's very slow. It's very relaxed. I don't feel like I would handle that too well, being from New Jersey. You know, I don't know. I've just heard a lot about, you know, everybody's got opinions about California. So you hear a lot of different things, but I may love it. That's very true. I may love it.
Yep,
but yet again, well, I guess if I could afford Jersey, I could probably afford California.
Oh yeah.
Have a nice day.
Take care, Ken.
Thank you.
Bye, everybody.
Bye. See you tomorrow.
I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. See everybody tomorrow morning. Bye, Ann. Bye, Jane. Goodbye, Dave.
How do I do this? I'm trapped.
I got it.